Is your audio not lining up to your video and you can't get it dialed in perfectly because it's off by less than one frame? Trust me, I know that frustration. And if you're a little OCD like me, out of sync audio is not an option. So let me show you the option that you do have right inside of DaVinci Resolve 17 to fix it. Over here on the edit page of DaVinci Resolve, the first thing we need to do is be able to move our audio independently of our linked video. And to do that, just click Disabled Link Selection by clicking the chain link icon. The shortcut key is Command-Shift-L. Disabling link selection, it temporarily lets you move clips separately, but it still remembers that they actually belong together. Let's also disable snapping while we're over here, which is going to get rid of that automatic magnetic behavior that clips have at their cut points. And now that that's all set up, here are the two ways to sync audio clips at the subframe level. Let's start with the mouse method. Start by zooming into the timeline by holding Option on a Mac, Alt on a PC, and zoom in close, like really, really close. Don't be shy. Now you have the option to just click and drag your audio clip exactly where you want it. You can even click and drag the edit point so it's not parked directly on a frame. Now this only works with audio clips, not video clips, but it's really that simple. It's crazy easy, right? You'll start to see red out of sync indicators just to the left of the link icon on your moved clips. And if you want them to go back into how they started, you just right click on that red offset timecode number to move the audio segment back into sync with move into place. You can actually also slip the clip into place, which means moving the internal guts of the clip without changing the in and out points on the timeline. Slip and move others, those are options too, but I wouldn't use those. Now let's take a look at how to use a keyboard shortcut instead of the mouse to get as accurate as 1/10 of a frame. If you go under the trim menu, you'll see there's an option to slip audio one subframe in either direction. This is pretty awesome. Now, this time instead of clicking the disabled link selection icon to select only a specific audio track segment of a clip, another thing you can do is instead of doing that, you can hold down the option button while you're clicking. This is gonna save you time because you don't need to go turn linked selection back on afterwards. So now you can slip the internal audio of the clip by 1/10 of a frame with option right and option left arrows on your keyboard. See those waveforms move? Pretty sweet. One word of warning using this keyboard slip method is you're not going to get out of sync indicators. So if you start using option left and option right arrows, make sure you pay attention to what you're doing. Hey, I'm calling a real quick timeout right now because I want to welcome you if this is your first time here. This channel is called Creative Video Tips. It's all about helping you create videos that make a difference and stand out. I'm Chadwick, and I'd love if you're into that to subscribe right now so you don't miss out on more great DaVinci Resolve tips. Now let's get back to the video. If you ever have a need to unlink audio from video, you can do that with a right click after highlighting them and uncheck link clips. This can actually be really handy in reverse to link things together like titles, composites, sound effects, things that you might want to attach like together, move together. In Final Cut Pro, this is like making a connected clip. Command Option L is the keyboard shortcut, and you'll know if it's linked by the chain link icon. You can toggle that on and off with that shortcut. A couple caveats to know. Just in case you need more than 1/10 frame accuracy, you can always go to the Fairlight page and move audio down to the sample rate. And in case you're having any trouble moving at the subframe level on the edit page, take a look at your user preferences. Under editing, align audio edits to frame boundaries is an option. You want to make sure that's unchecked, which it should be by default. You just want to make sure. The top three ways I use subframe audio editing is one, to align a mix that comes back slightly out of sync. It's perfect for that. The other one is to align the phase or latency of mismatched microphones. Like if you have a wireless and a wired mic, the wireless one's always gonna be a little bit behind. And the final one that you're probably gonna need it for is to time up music perfectly so that it lands on a visual hit. And now you've mastered subframe audio editing in DaVinci Resolve. If you found this video helpful at all, give it a like so that other filmmakers can find it too. And if you wanna learn more about DaVinci Resolve, filmmaking in general, click the playlist that I have on screen right now. And because there's so much more to learn, I'll see you in that next video.